I'm going to begin by reading the obituaries written by her parents. Once upon a time, our little girl, Aspyn Mary Rose, entered our lives and changed it forever. Aspyn was born on a beautiful summer day, Monday, May 1st, 2017. She was a princess from the minute she was born and began doing her life her own way. Her fighting spirit and stubbornness were on full display throughout her five-year journey. Her determination was underestimated from the start, from surviving helicopter ride to solar eclipse to 112-day stay in the NICU. We were able to be by her side every step of the way. The doctors told us that she would not make it past birth, and if she had happened to make it, she would never have a full life. We were told she would never be able to see, but her eyes lit up every time someone walked into the room. We were told she would be deaf, but responded to voices by turning her head. We were told she would never laugh, smile, or show emotions, but if you knew her, you know she had a personality full of sass and orneriness. She filled our home with laughter and happiness. Over the years, many came to love and adore Aspyn. Our community, friends, and family have shown us so much support through text, phone calls, visits, and numerous fundraisers that were held in her honor. Each of her five birthdays were celebrated in style. She was able to travel with us to numerous places, including Disney World, Great Wolf Lodge, San Antonio, the beach, and the yearly family trip to Branson. There was not a sporting event or family activity that Aspyn was not able to attend. Aspen's fighting spirit, her strong will to survive, and God's plan for her life carried her through the good days and bad days. With God's grace and mercy, along with the power of prayer, Aspyn was able to outlive what anyone thought was possible. And on Wednesday, August 31st, 2022, Aspyn walked for the first time in the arms of Jesus, and her sweet little body was fully restored. And they put 1 Samuel 1:27. I looked that verse up because I was curious. And I'll read it to you. It says, For this child I prayed, and the Lord hath given me my petition, which I ask of him. Good verse. Her family include her parents, Kevin and Jamie Randall, sisters Maddie, Emerson, and Holland, her brother Tegan, all of the home, grandparents Steve and Debbie Randall of Tonkawa, Tammy and Johnny Scorgum of Ponca City, James Dyer of Haltom City, Texas, great-grandparents Jerry and Carol Belair of Blackwell, aunts and uncles, Ryan and Katie Randall, Shane Randall of Tonkawa, Jennifer and Joe Johnson of Georgia, and Corey Dyer of Haltom City, Texas, cousins Jake and Reed Randall of Tonkawa, and Trapper and Parker Johnson of Georgia, and numerous extended family members. She was preceded in death by her great-grandparents, Ruel and Sharon Case, Clifford, Dortha Randall, and Jim and Mary, Aspen's namesake, Farrell, Leroy Dyer, and Bill Wright. Let's pray. Bless you, God. Bless you for your goodness and your mercy, and God, the love that you've extended, Lord, toward us, toward this family. Thank you for Aspyn's life. Lord, the difference she made wherever she was, the difference she made and to her family and to all those that knew her. And God, we thank you, Lord, for the difference she made. Lord, your presence always being there, a testimony, a witness always being given of your great love and mercy, Lord, toward us. God, right now, we just invite you into this place. Holy Spirit, we acknowledge you, and that God, you comfort as only you can comfort. The great comforter, come alongside us. And may everything is said and done here today not only honor Aspyn's life, but may it bring glory and honor to you as well. We pray these things believing in the name of Jesus. Amen. Scripture reading is going to be in found in 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 3 through 9. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, which according to his abundant mercy hath begotten us again unto a lively hope by the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance incorruptible and undefiled, and that fadeth not away, reserved in heaven for you, who are kept by the power of God through faith unto salvation, ready to be revealed in the last time, wherein ye greatly rejoice, though now for a season, if need be, ye are in heaviness through the manifold temptations, that the trial of your faith, being much more precious than gold that perisheth, though it be tried with fire, might be found unto the praise and honor and glory at the appearing of Jesus Christ, whom having not seen, ye love, in whom though now ye see him not, yet believing, ye rejoice with joy unspeakable and full of glory, receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your souls.
Closer to you, then I will go through the fire. as I let you go. Gonna tell you how much I love you, though you think you already know. I remember I thought you looked like an angel wrapped in pink, so soft and warm. You've had me wrapped around your finger since the day you were born. From the outside in, chase your dreams, but always know the road that'll lead you home again. Go on, take on this old world, but to me you know you'll always be. My trouble, that crooked little smile milled my heart of stone. Now look at you, I've turned around and you've almost grown. Sometimes you're asleep, I whisper I love you in the moonlight at your door. As I walk away, I hear you say, Daddy, love you more. You beautiful baby from the in, chase your dreams, but always know the road that'll lead you home again. Go on, take on this whole world, but to me you know you'll always be my little girl. Say yes to him unless I know he's the half that makes you whole. He has a poet's soul and the heart of a man's man. I know he'll say that he's in love, but between you and me, he won't be good enough. You beautiful baby from the outside, chase your dreams, but always know the road that'll lead you home again. Go on, take on this old world, but to me you know you'll always be my little girl.
Take chances, but they're worth taking. Loving might be a mistake, but it's worth making. Don't let some helping heart leave you bitter. When you come close to selling out, reconsider. Give the heavens above more than just a passing glance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance, I hope you do. Promise me that you'll give faith a fighting chance. And when you get the choice to sit it out or dance.
Angel lullabies. It is not right that we are here. It's not right that humans endure the things that Aspyn and her family have. It's not right that death has claimed another daughter and sister and friend, and it's painful. And the reason it's painful is because human beings were not meant to die. Human beings were meant to live forever in bodies that never break down, on an earth that never decays, in perfect love with the Lord and in perfect fellowship with one another. That's how the story starts. You open up to the beginning of your Bible. God makes all things and calls it very good. But because of man's refusal to walk in God's ways and instead go our own, death enters into the story. And so because of our sin, our bodies will go into the dirt. All of us will face death. That's the bad news. And that's why it rips our heart out whenever death claims another person, however old or however young. But I have good news. It's my job. I have good news, and it's news that God announced just moments after Adam and Eve rebelled, and it's what disciples and worshipers of Jesus Christ call the gospel. And the good news is this, the gospel is this, that God has a solution to our problem of death and sin and sadness and suffering. God has a solution to ventilators and feeding tubes and surgeries. God's solution to the problem of sin and death is resurrection. It's the undoing of death, which means one day we will be done with funerals. One day we'll be done with the sting of sin and death week after week, month after month, year after year. Believers will be done with funerals because the Lord that we follow, the one that was crucified and rose again, the one we follow made promises that one day, a great day, sin and death would die. And God would restore the heavens and the earth and our bodies to glory forever. This is the good news that Christians believe. That this is the gospel. We believe that now is not always. We believe that things won't be this way forever. We believe there is an appointed end to sadness and suffering and death. But on days like today, before that great day, we grieve and we mourn. By Aspyn's death, we're reminded that this world is not right yet. And in moments like these, we have the sure word of the Lord that He is near to the brokenhearted today. And He saves those who are crushed in spirit. God is not removed from the pain today. He's not distant in it. He's here by His Spirit, and He's here by His people who will imperfectly help you guys. We will not do it perfectly, but we'll do our best. The Lord is near to the brokenhearted, and He saves those crushed in spirit. However, our ultimate comfort doesn't come from the knowledge that the Lord cares about our situation. The Lord's answer for grief at all times, and the Lord's answer for grief today, is not, "I'm so sorry, that is so sad." Jesus actually has a solution to the problem. On the day that Jesus wept with Mary and Martha when their brother died, Jesus also said this, "Your brother will rise again." Then He said, "I am the resurrection and the life." And He says to you today, Kevin, Jamie, your daughter will rise again. Absolutely will rise again. And when she rises, she will not and you will not be working with ventilators and feeding tubes. Aspyn will not have to struggle and fight to get through the day. Aspyn will laugh unhindered. She will sing. She will run. She will play. And all she'll know, is pure joy in the new world that God has made. Because on the day when Jesus returns, then shall come to pass that's written, death is swallowed up in victory. Death, where's your sting today? Where's your victory? It's gone. This is good news for Aspyn. She will rise again. And this is good news for the Randalls. Now is not always. These momentary light afflictions are preparing for you an eternal weight of glory. And this is good news for anyone who trusts in it. Anyone who turns from their sin and turns to the Lord with all of their heart, soul, mind, and strength. And if you don't know what that looks like, what it means to turn to the Lord and receive forgiveness unto eternal life, if you're from Tonkawa, find me. I'd love to tell you. Love to walk through it with you. So we grieve for Aspyn today. We grieve with the Randalls today. We grieve for what sin and death have wrought. But we do not grieve as those without hope. For we believe that Jesus died and rose again. Even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with the cry of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the sound of the trumpet of God. And the dead in Christ will rise to never die again. Let's pray. Father, thank you for the gospel. Thank you for this anchor we have. Thank you for this hope we have, that you are faithful to finish what you started, that you are faithful to your promise to undo death, that you're faithful to your promise to be near to the brokenhearted and save those who are crushed in spirit. And so we ask you for help to walk the path. We ask you for help to stay in the race until you come. We love you. In Jesus' name, amen.
I've gotta keep the calm before the storm. I don't want less, I don't want more. Must bar the windows and the doors to keep me safe, to keep me warm. Yeah, my life is worth. Can't reach the shore, and my voice becomes a driving force. I won't let this pull me overboard. God, keep my head above water.
Are you past the point of weary? Is your burden weighing heavy? Is it all too much to carry? Let me tell you about my Jesus. Do you feel that empty feeling? 'Cause shame's done all it's stealing, and you're desperate for some healing. Let me tell you about my Jesus. He makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can save. Let me tell you about my Jesus. His love is strong and his grace is free. And the good news is I know that he can do for you what he's done for me. Let me tell you about my Jesus. And let my Jesus change your life. Appeal. Let me tell you about my Jesus and all the wrong turns that you would go on to if you could. Who can work it all for your good? Let me tell you about my Jesus. He makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can save. Let me tell you about my Jesus.
Tell you about my Jesus. Oh,
he makes a way where there ain't no way. Rises up from an empty grave. Ain't no sinner that he can save. Let me tell you about my Jesus.
Hallelujah.
your praise forevermore. Jesus, our God, unstoppable. Nothing shall be impossible. Your kingdom reigns unstoppable. We'll shout your praise forevermore.
Atmosphere is changing now, for the Spirit of the Lord is here. The evidence is all around that the Spirit of the Lord is here. The atmosphere is changing now, is all around that the Spirit of the Lord is here. Overflow in this place, fill our hearts with your love. Your love surrounds us. You're the reason we came to encounter. All around.
together from the depths of our hearts tonight.
Spirit of God, fall fresh on us. We need your presence. Your kingdom come, your will be done here as in heaven. Spirit of God, fall fresh on us. We need your presence. Your kingdom come, your will be done here as in heaven. Spirit of God, fall fresh on us. We need your presence. Your kingdom come, your will be done here as in
What makes Tonkawa great, in my opinion, is not the geological location. It's not the town, but it's the people. It's the reason why, even after all these years, I eagerly come back, because of the relationships and the closeness. What makes Tonkawa great is the Randalls and the Rectors, Wheatheart. They were my neighbors. I'm very tempted to quote maybe one of Kevin's rivals, but like a good neighbor, I won't finish, but I'll say this. Some 127 verse 3 says this. It says, behold, children are a gift from God. The fruit of your womb is a reward. And I think I have to proclaim this today. Aspyn was, is, and will always be a gift from God. She is a gift. Kevin and Jamie text me this week a scripture in Psalms 46 verse 4 and 5, and it says this: there is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy dwellings, the holy dwelling place of the Most High. God is in the midst of her. She will not be moved. God will help her when the morning dawns. Here we see God is compared to a river which surrounds and defends a city. God is said to be dwelling in the midst of the city, not only being its security, but also producing security as well. The idea here is that the dawn will break after an anxious or hard night. Zephaniah chapter 3, verse 17 says this: the Lord your God is in your midst, a victorious warrior. He will exalt over you with joy. He will be quiet over you in love. He will rejoice over you with shouts of joy. It's very common, the most common lie maybe, that the enemy uses to instill fear and hurt and tell us is that God is absent or far from us. Isaiah chapter 41 verse 10 says this, "Do not fear, for I am with you. Do not be anxious. Look about, for I am your God, and I will strengthen you. Surely I will help you. Surely I will uphold you with my righteous hand." Deuteronomy tells us to be strong, be courageous. Do not be afraid or tremble, for the Lord your God goes with you. He will not fail you or forsake you. My message to the Randalls and your family today, that in the hardest times, God is truly with you. He is in the midst of you, and he will bring forth the light and the dawn again. I'll close with reading Matthew 28, verse 20. Jesus says this to his disciples before he leaves to heaven. He says, teaching them to observe all that I've commanded you to do, and I will always be with you, even to the end of time. Pastor Josh most eloquently reminded us that we have a hope, and that hope is that Christ will come again, and we will certainly get to see baby Aspyn again. But the truth is, oftentimes we think of that in a futuristic idea, like one day when we die, we get God. But the good news today is you get him today. In your grief, he comforts you. In your hardship, he's right there with you. So I pray, may the peace of God go before you, and may you feel his presence even today. Let us pray. God of peace, we pray that you would give peace. God of comfort, we pray you comfort. God who promises that you will never leave us, never leave us. In the hardships and in the trials, would you continue to remind us of the smiles, of the joy, of the happy moments, and that you would set our eyes to a day in which you would come again, and that we would be reunited in the clouds. Father, I pray that even as we go from this place, that we would only go towards your presence and your nearness. We thank you as we remember, as we celebrate a gift. We thank you that that gift will never leave us. In Jesus' name, amen. At the conclusion of this song, we will dismiss the family first. I'll turn the service over to the funeral home.